I'm going to describe how to use the interactive simulation that's located at this location on the Wolfram site. And what it does is compare the time for reaction in the batch reactor when the reaction is carried out at constant pressure, like a piston and cylinder arrangement, or it's carried out at constant volume. And there's going to be a difference in the time for a certain conversion because of the fact there's a mole change. If there's a mole change, then the volume will change in the constant pressure system, which affects the concentrations. And so the final conversion can be changed. The reaction order, the higher the reaction order, the bigger the difference between the two. And the moles of product form per mole reactant. In other words, one mole of A goes to 2.5 moles of B. That's going to affect how much difference there is between the constant volume and the constant pressure, because as more moles form and the constant pressure reactor expands more, the concentration decreases. So we'll go and look at the simulation on the Wolfram site. So here's the interactive simulation. You notice there is a difference. The constant pressure reactor requires more time in case when one mole reaction goes to two moles of products. If I were to increase this number, then the time difference becomes larger. If I were to make it one, then there's no difference because we're not increasing the number of moles of reaction, then we're not expanding the piston and diluting our reactant. But if we are indeed increasing the number of moles, now, if I increase the reaction order, notice there's a bigger difference because that dilution has a bigger effect when the reaction is second order. And of course, as I go to higher conversions, now it's a bigger time difference, and of course, it takes longer for a reaction. So you can use this simulation to get a better idea of the difference between a constant pressure and a constant volume reactor. These are both isothermal batch reactors.